mention, Amaya is the youngest one.
We were talking about that. Her birthday is in June, and my birthday is in May.
We're almost there.
We're
almost there. And you have been a Eurovision fan since ever.
Since ever.
I would say since you were young, because it wouldn't make any sense. But actually, I think I discovered something, a fun fact, maybe not that fun, is that Iceland started in 86 in Eurovision, and just didn't participate in two times. And one of those times was in the Eurovision.
Oh, 98.
You don't have an Icelandic Eurovision song from your ear. From your ear. Are you depressed because of that?
No.
He's always smiling. That's what I like about him. He's always smiling. You're singing a song with a very important message.
Yeah.
And this is contagious, guys. You are always there with a huge smile, with that energy. How can you do it? Okay, you're 19, but even though...
Going through life is so much easier with a smile than without a smile. So
why you are not always that?
Why not always smile?
Yeah.
You know.
Next question. In your song, you say in every language, it doesn't work for love. Of course, that's a metaphor. Mm-hmm. But how do you say love in Icelandic?
Ást.
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 Yeah.
In Portuguese, it's love. It's love. It's oh God. This is going well. Okay. It's amor.
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 Yeah.
Yeah.
And if you had to pick a word, to choose a word for Eurovision.
Amor.
Amor. For me, it's amor.
Yeah.
When I think about Iceland in Eurovision, and before I met you, of course, the word I would choose would be Sika.
Sika?
Yeah.
Seagull, like as in the bird?
No.
As no, Sika Vintage.
Yeah, Sika!
Sika! Iceland is not perfect. I'm starting to learn, but it's not perfect because she was in 1992 and 1994. You know her songs?
We know one.
No, actually, one of my favorite songs ever from all the countries is Nedaya. I'm being serious.
Nedaya?
Yeah. Could you sing it for her? Yeah.
Oh my God, thank you very much!
This is actually one of my favorite songs ever. How did the second... Thank you very much. Louis, a big applause, please. Thank you very, very much. So how did the second rehearsal go?
It went really well. Extra boost of courage this time. And just the development of the staging is coming out really well on camera, and we're just really excited to move forward. It went really well. It was amazing.
So what are your expectations?
Well, our expectations are this is going to be the best night of my life, really. I think this is going to be one of the most amazing moments in my life. So
yeah, but you won a scholarship.
Yeah.
And you're going to study.
Yeah.
The Royal Academy of Music in London.
Yeah.
Yeah. But in your song, you sing, "We all have a choice. We can make it."
Yeah.
So imagine that you win this.
That I win this.
Yeah. You win this.
Yeah.
So after summer, what will happen? Will you focus just in your career, in concerts and tours and studios? You have to make that choice. Or no? Going to school,
going
to study. It's a difficult choice.
Yeah, it's a really difficult choice. But I made that choice. I've made that choice in my head, obviously. And I want to master my craft before I go into my career. So my plan was always to go to the Royal Academy of Music. But if I win, it's obviously going to change a few things. Maybe I'm going to...
What do you mean by a few?
I might not take a master's degree or something like that, but I'm always going to school. That was my goal. I wanted to go to the Royal Academy, and I wanted to master my voice.
That's
and
great.
The craft. So that was always going to be, I want to be the best that I can be. So
that's
going to school is...
That's it.
That's
great. That's great.
Thank you.
What about you guys? You ask questions. Yes, please.
How are you, man?
Good morning, Ali. Nice to see you again. JP from Radio International. In Iceland, you've been playing musicals, and can you tell us which musicals you've been in? And Selma has been directing those musicals?
I want to know.
Yes.
Sorry for that big one.
No. I just didn't have the time to ask that.
Selma has been at Eurovision twice, and has been giving you advice how to go about it. And the last question I have is to do with your impersonation. You're an impersonator.
Okay.
Could you give us an impression of somebody famous?
All right, I'll start on the impersonation. So I love to do Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Yeah, that was the before, this is the after.
Go to the chapa. And I also do Yoda. So
I like it.
I'm grateful I am to be here.
So I was in Oliver Twist, and I starred as Oliver Twist when I was 11. And some of yours directed me when I was at that musical. And then I was in The Wizard of Oz, and Thorna the Clausen, which is the first time we met, she was directing the children in the group. And she was the director there.
Oh, how was it?
He was amazing. Yeah.
Yeah, you're just saying that.
No.
Because he's okay.
Yeah, that's because and that's why I hired him again, because he wasn't amazing.
may I just ask one question? I really like Oliver. I'm definitely not like you, but when I was younger, I was blonde.
Oh, yeah.
So I watched Oliver, and I'm Oliver. What's your favorite song from Oliver? Food, Glorious Food, or Pick a Bucket or Two?
No, it's definitely Where Is Love. Where is love? It's the song where he cries.
You can't sing a little bit more.
Yeah, I don't remember the lyrics, but it's... does it come from far above? I think it's yeah. And at the end of that song, he cries because he's all alone, and he doesn't have any family. And that was in the premiere. The president of Iceland and his first mate were at the front row, and when I sang that song to them. Like the president for me was like a super big deal, so I cried and cried and cried, and everyone was like, "Wow, he's such a good actor!" and I couldn't stop crying until the other act came. I was still crying, doing my lines with the other actors, and that was at the premiere, so it went really well.
I'm an actor. I will ask some important people to be there always, because that's a good technique. Next question, please. The mic time. Hey, beautiful lady, how are you? Good morning. Thank you for the
Hey, Iceland.
Hello.
I'm Simon from Poland, Radio Newsletter. I have a soccer question. Of course, we are waiting for Icelandic clapping.
Yes.
I was saving that for the end, but you go.
But... Well, the question is about you and Croatia. Actually, you have something in common. You are not only in the World Cup together, but in the semi-final.
Yeah.
By the way, Franka's boyfriend is on the national team.
Oh, really?
Yes.
You had soccer in your national final, right? Mm. So who will be better, Croatia or you, here in the Eurovision and in Russia?
I'm gonna answer that one by saying, of course, we will win Croatia in the World Cup, and in here, you'll never know, because it's not about the competition, it's about the love and the artistry and the music, so I can't really make up my mind on that one, but definitely, when it comes to soccer, we're gonna beat their ass.
Well, I don't know if I like that answer, because Portugal is in the competition as well.
Yeah.
And we have Ronaldo, and actually we really like him.
Yeah, you didn't beat us as well. That was 1-1.
Ronaldo didn't score. You had that one. You had that one. Yes, please.
Hi, Ari. Alistair Birch from Eurofile. I'd like to go back to The Wizard of Oz. I understand you played multiple parts. Can you tell us which ones? How did you keep them apart? And who's your favorite character from the play?
All right, my favorite character is the Tin Man, because he wants a heart, he wants a human heart, and that one got me really well. But I was a Oompa Loompa, so I was like, I was the blue Oompa Loompa, and then I was a flying monkey, and then I was a crow, and then I was a very sharp looking. Pedestrian from the green city, like the big city, Emerald City. Ah, wait, what did I do? Then I was a soldier, with a really long hat. I was a soldier, and then I was. I think that was. That's it. Yeah.
Then you have a very good memory.
Characters, because do you like the Wizard of Oz?
Of course.
Do you like The Wizard of Oz? And you like musicals?
Yep.
Did you watch Wicked already?
No, I haven't seen it. I have to see it. When I was in London for my audition, I was picking and choosing between The Book of Mormon and Wicked.
Oh, they are both.
Yeah, and I went to see Book of Mormon.
But then you like The Wicked Witch of Oz.
When I go in August, I'm definitely going to see Wicked.
Do that. Yeah. It's a great one. Yes, please. In the morning, my English goes even more Pikachu. It's like,
hi. Good morning. Hello. Martijn van der Veen from Eurovision Artists in the Netherlands. I was wondering what makes you more maybe nervous going to live and move to and live in London, taking part in the Eurovision Song Contest, or parachuting.
Definitely parachuting. That was the most stressful experience of my life, because when those doors open in 11,000 feet, you just shit your pants like that. That is the worst sound that you get in your ears, like, and then you notice that you have to jump and land. But in those 50 seconds, it's the best feeling ever. So I'm definitely going again. I have a t-shirt that says, don't be afraid of the fall, be afraid of the addiction. So, and it's true.
Then you get the thing.
Yeah.
More questions? No, actually, you have the guitar. What was it for us?
We were going to do another medley.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Well, that would be great, because I was jealous. We did it the first time, and now I'm not going to.
We got to do a special one for you.
Well, thank you for that.
Yeah. Okay, come on.
Mama, someone broke my heart again. Now I'm gonna ease my pain. Dancing on the floor. Oh, someone broke my heart again. Tell her I can take my pain, take it anymore. I'm a golden boy, coming to enjoy and to clean up fun. Let me show you how we do. I'm a golden boy, coming to enjoy. And before I leave, let me show you.
Down the road I stopped to listen. I hear your laughter in the trees. You whisper in the breeze, my love is you.
oh, 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 it's time to go. I'll see you soon. 'Cause I can't wait tomorrow. Say the things I want to say. Smile will always lead my way. I can't wait. I'm coming soon. I just want to see your face again.
Voltas a querer. E eu sei que não se ama sozinho. Talvez te lagarino possas voltar a aprender.
Thank you so much!
Let's do the thing.
I want everybody to stand up. Can we all stand up?
Oh,
all right. Even you at the back, you don't get. So you get your hands up. Get your hands up. Up. All right. Let me do it like this. Let me do it like this.
Thank you.